In the year 2009, Governor Babatunde Rajifasola's administration took a giant leap in agriculture. In October of that year, a new concept in agricultural rebirth was inaugurated as the first set of 100 trainees were admitted into the Agriculture Youth Empowerment Scheme, Agric Yes. Agric Yes was conceptualized to address two critical issues, youth empowerment and development of agriculture. It is therefore a unique project being specially driven by the Office of the Senior Special Assistant to the Governor on Special Projects in collaboration with the Ministry of Agriculture and Cooperatives.
Agriculture is the greatest employer of labor, and this project is set up to also stem rural-urban migration. If we develop the rural area, we'll be able to curtail or reduce the number of our youth coming to the urban cities for white-collar jobs. So in our drive to develop urban area, at the same time the rural area, Agriculture Youth Empowerment Scheme was set up, address youth unemployment, address rural and urban migration problem, and also enhance the food security of Lagos. Lagos State, with our population, we need to be able to desist from the invertebrate habit of depending on imported foodstuff all the time. We should be able to produce what we eat. If we cannot produce, or at least a reasonable percentage, from 25% to 30%, is what is driving this project.
Agric Yes target is to empower its trainees in four core subject areas. These include vegetable farming, poultry, aquaculture and beekeeping. It also emphasizes the knowledge of agri-business for its participants.
The program has a concept note which was designed and debated at the floor of the Executive Council and approved. So we know from beginning to end what we want to do. And now the issue is that every year down the program, we have specific targets that we have set out for ourselves.
To effectively do justice to these subjects, Agric Yes has a three-phase implementation strategy. The first phase is a 6-month intensive training centered around the core subjects. The second phase is another 6-month internship period. This allows the trainees to be exposed to international best practices and management techniques in modern agriculture in private commercial farms. In the third phase, being the exit stage, successful trainees are permanently settled in farm estates.
For the past 30 years or thereabout, I don't know of any program in the agricultural sector that have been so conscious of, you know, bridging the gap between the old farmers and the young farmers. Nowadays, most of our youth don't want to take farming as a profession. They would rather want to ride Okada, sell recharge card, do fast business that will bring in money, but cannot sustain family in the long run. As a result, this program has consciously identified the gap and quickly moved in to bridge that gap by producing 1,000 army that will fit in this club that we are going to experience.
In the Agric Yes curriculum, intensive farming is the watchword in both scientific and practical ways of maximizing production with limited land input. It thus targets radical expansion in production of vegetables, poultry, aquaculture and beekeeping.
These four put together, every one of us, we have developed the passion. Coming into Agric Yes, we were reorientated about our passion in terms of entrepreneurial skill was being inputted in us, so such that whatever business, whatever venture we desire to uptake in this field of agriculture, we can boldly say that yes, we are going to make it and succeed in it.
It has really changed my orientation that I want to be a farmer. When I came in, I thought it's just going to be a thing that you just have to do and go away. But by the time I came and I started, I think it's a thing that I can live.
By design, Agric Yes is to equip, engage and empower youths in Lagos State. an intervention project that will give birth to a group of elite farmers who will extend the frontiers of agricultural development in the state.
Certainly, we have kept to that vision, and what is more important is that we want to ensure that entrepreneurship, the spirit of entrepreneurship, is what guides everything that we are doing. And we are not only, you know, imparting knowledge, you know, cutting-edge technologies, we are also training, molding character, letting them be good and responsible citizens, community leaders in future. So the vision is really is what has kept us going, and we are very happy that we are keeping to it.
In addition to the status of Lagos as the nation's economic, commercial and industrial capital, Agric Yes program will no doubt bring a fresh breath of air into the state's economy by setting new standards in modern agricultural production for Nigeria. With the expected empowerment of 1,000 laptop-carrying farmers who will set up their own businesses and employ others, government is equipping a brand of determined and highly ambitious young agro-entrepreneurs that are set to unleash their potentials in agriculture.
The experience is just something that it's going to take me days and months to count down. I just came up with something as I was standing awaiting interview that Lagos State government is like a gun, and we present here we are like the bullets, and they've just shot us, and the sky is just our limit. We are also laser guided, so we are not going to miss target.
It's just as if I'm being induced again to, you know, get the drive to move this agriculture thing in Nigeria forward, and most importantly, Lagos State.
A unique driving force behind this program is the caliber of resource personnel this program enjoys. The trainees are being tutored by national and international experts in agriculture. Of special mention is the partnership that has been established with Hebrew University of Israel. This linkage gives the students the rare privilege of acquiring first-class knowledge from Israeli tutors.
The priority of my objective is to become one of the most successful poultry producers in the whole world, especially in the area of egg production. And one of the ways to achieve that has been both facilitators that we've been exposed to within and outside Nigeria. As 2 weeks ago, we had one of the best poultry facilitators in the whole world, in the person of Professor Rosenborg. Again, he came all the way from Israel. And we also have local facilitators from University of Agriculture, Abeokuta. They always call me on a weekly basis to give a series of eye-opening lectures in poultry, fish farming, agribusiness, vegetable production. And these are avenues that the hidden talent in us could be brought out.
The internship stage is quite critical for trainees. Exposure to modern best practices is the main focus. In this phase, trainees are attached to established commercial farms for practical, hands-on experience.
The experience were interesting in both places, because at Felima, went to a fish farm to see what the practical aspect. Yes, we have been taught the theoretical aspect here and also the practical aspect of our agricultural section here. But at Felima, we're able to see things, you know, in an experiential way. There's a difference between the training and going to where they have been producing over time. And so a training aspect here, an experiential aspect over there, joining the two together to make us better.
What I have learned here, I'll tell you, guarantees a bright tomorrow for me and a bright tomorrow for the nation at large. Because what I have learned here, I'm going to share with anybody that comes my way. In the process, the population of aquaculture practitioners will go up. And I'll tell you, fish availability is guaranteed.
Talk of from the hatchery to growers to the table size fish, you need a very good maintenance. Talk out about the water quality, what makes the water quality, about dissolved oxygen, temperature, alkalinity, salinity. Talk about everything. You learned so much there, and personally, I still want to go back there to learn more.
Governor Babatunde Rajifasola's administration also made good its promise, as 9 best students among course 1 trainees left the shores of Nigeria for Israel for their 6 months internship program.
It's a very gladdening thing. It's a promise made and a promise fulfilled. At the beginning of the program, as part of the overall program concept, the idea is to borrow from performance, to people who are doing very well, to look at them and copy what they are doing. We don't want to reinvent the wheel. We know countries that have done very well in agriculture. We know how they have come about, what they have done, and we want to also do the same. So we told these trainees to be good both in learning and character, and we assess them in all these parameters. They will go to Israel, they will be exposed to the best technologies that is available anywhere in the world. They will come back here, they will become role models, they will become examples for the other 91 to copy from. So every year we hope we can sustain this.
Agric Yes is a 5-year tenured program that plans to raise 1,000 world-class agricultural entrepreneurs, a new breed of laptop-carrying farmers that will set new standards in agricultural production. To achieve this, the Agricultural Training Institute, ARAGA, which serves as the training center for Agric Yes, now has sophisticated training and support facilities that will help achieve the dream of this program.
If we really want to catch up, if we really want to be competitive, we should enhance the skill of our trainees in cutting-edge technology. We can't continue the drudgeries of agriculture that is even making our youth avoid agriculture. So we need to bring in the latest technology in agriculture, and that is why we are using the state-of-the-art equipment we have there. We have retainership with the people that installed it, and our boys and girls are well trained on this. They can also take over from the team of expatriates we have. We are not just letting the expatriates take over, they are understudying the expatriates. And these are youth, they are graduates of Nigerian universities.
I was amazed by the way the things have been done over here. All the buildings you see around you were not existing. It was built during that time. Well, renovated, built some of them. The investment that the state of Lagos and the governor through the SSA, Mr. Lawal, invested over here, it's amazing. It's a lot of money invested over here. Now we have some greenhouse, we have a drip irrigation system.
A conducive environment is therefore provided for the trainees. Among facilities already acquired by the Governor Babatunde Rajifasola administration include 10,000 capacity fully automated layer pens, greenhouse for vegetable farming, 10 fish hatcheries with capacity to produce 5,000 fingerlings, complete water recirculatory system, drip irrigation system, among others. There is also a library, an auditorium with multimedia facilities, and syndicate rooms for discussions and seminars. The Cyber Cafe or ICT Center is equipped with 25 computers. This, along with every other facility, is linked to the web via broadband wireless and VESA technologies. This will enable the trainees to carry out research on the internet anywhere within the institute. Sporting, viewing and relaxation facilities are also provided.
Gaussians and Nigerians as a whole should expect a lot from this program, because really it's not just about a group of 100 people being together and producing. It's more of a community thing. It's more of, you know, a social thing. You know, you get together, you produce, people come, they eat there, you know, all that is there. But at the same time, it's more of being together, of a community-based thing. You have a community that you live together, you do things together, you learn to interact, and within those community, you groom leaders who are likely to be future leaders of tomorrow in Nigeria.
For the current 200 trainees and those yet to join Agric Yes, several motivational packages are being offered by government. These include monthly stipend as trainee salary while working as interns, free daily meals and accommodation, allocation of 1 hectare of land each for permanent settlement, empowerment through takeoff grants, and linkage to the Lagos State Microfinance Institution, LASMI. Government also guarantees as buyer of last resort for all produce.
This is an entrepreneurial skill development. So they are being trained, they are being taught how to become entrepreneurs. They are job creators and not job seekers. After all the training, the internship, they are to be employers of labor. In the next 5 years, we're looking at 1,000 minimum of well-trained farmers, laptop-carrying farmers. When they finish, the minimum workforce they can have is 4 per person. So in the next 5 years, we are looking at 4,000 new employees, new labor that will be employed in the agricultural sector. Only by the agri-KS farmers, because we are creating jobs, we are at the same time protecting jobs, because directly they will employ people, indirectly they also, by the time they produce the value chain, the market, people that will buy their produce, the packaging, the processing aspect of it, a lot of more hands will be employed. We are going to enhance the employability of a lot of people in agricultural sector and the agro-allied sectors. That is what we are talking about here. You know, agriculture is the greatest employer of labor. 70% of Nigerians are directly and indirectly involved in the agriculture. So that is what we are talking about here. So we want to make it as attractive and as rewarding for urban youth.
We have a slogan here, which is that you will never work alone. Go into that profession and we will give you the support.
I see agriculture as a platform to fulfill dreams, because here we are engaged and we are empowered. We don't really have to go source for fund, source for loan from other places where you have to be turned down by some perhaps. But here we are given the training, and then with the backup, the empowerment that it requires for us to start off. And starting off with the training gives us the backbone that yes, this, I know what I am going into, and productivity is certain.
In order to ensure a well-rounded training, AgriCS provides an avenue for trainees to interact with role models who have been outstanding in their various fields of endeavor. This monthly program is to inspire the trainees to develop positive attitude to success through hard work. Among the guest lecturers who participated include Professor Wole Soyinka, the Nobel laureate, Dr. Kayode Fayemi, now Governor of Ekiti State, Mr. Ali Abdi, United States Agricultural Attaché in Nigeria, amongst others.
The Commissioner for Women Affairs and Poverty Alleviation, Prince Tadijoke Orelope, was also there to inspire them, to let them know that they have the support of the government and the taxpayers of Lagos, you understand. So they are the real revolutionaries we are talking about. They are going to change the face of agri sector in Lagos.
With the potentials of 1,000 trainees that will eventually become agricultural entrepreneurs who will set up their own business and employ others, AgriCS is poised to disprove everything that puts Lagos at disadvantage in agriculture, like its small size and industrial and commercial status.
You know, what AgriCS has done to people's life, you know, you cannot actually quantify it. It has really turned a lot of things about my life around. I only think, dream of Agric these days. All I do, I wake up in the morning, is Agric, afternoon Agric, in the night Agric. You wake up in the middle of the night, you got something doing. You are always thinking about the next move. The opportunity is there for you. They give us little supervision, which for you to achieve the best with little supervision within a very short period of time.
I feel as if I'm a superstar, doing it myself. I was taught that from Portion. You have to do it yourself. You are the master of all. Make sure you do it with your hands.
We've gotten fantastic results. On the broiler farm, we have met our target of 2 kg in 6 weeks. And in the layer section, we have we peak at about 95% production at 28 weeks, which was excellent because we were able to meet the target set by the breeders of the layer birds that we are using. And presently at about age 65 weeks, we are still on 85% production, which is excellent by the standard of the makers of the birds.
For Governor Babatunde Rajifasola's administration, the success of AgriCS will not only guarantee the food needs of the state's teeming population, it will surely provide holistic and enduring approach towards poverty alleviation and economic empowerment of youths.
The journey so far has been very interesting. We have seen a lot of difficulties which we have termed as challenges, and it has motivated us to think harder and even improvise in some ways. So far so good. We are very thankful first to His Excellency, the Governor of Lagos State, Mr. Babatunde Rajifasola, whose vision inspired us to come up with this program, and he has backed us up all the way during implementation. It's been wonderful. It is inspiring. It's one is very lucky to be involved with this novel project, a project that has been applauded by everyone that has stepped foot on this Agric Years project has commended it, and we are very, very lucky indeed to be part of this program.
This is a precursor to my coming back. You know, all the diasporas, we are planning to come back, and I'm trying to be a kind of a danger, just to call all this up, all these other guys all over the world, in the UK, America, Asia. There is more to be done in Nigeria, and Nigeria is moving on. I'm bringing down my family back to Nigeria after this program.
It has been recognized that for our nation to move out of the current level of underdevelopment, we need to set a solid basis for sustainable development and the long-term well-being of the people. Rebuilding infrastructure and radical investment in agriculture are among the challenges to be tackled.
Is about those our cousins, our brothers, our friends that are unemployed, that have been unemployed after university education, 4 or 5 years, they're still roaming the streets, they're in the labor market looking for jobs. This is a safety net for them, that they can do it, they can get there, they can be employer of labor themselves. The government of Fashola want to de-emphasize the negativity attached to a Nigerian youth, and see the potential in Nigerian youth as.
I really want to say a big thank you, profound appreciation to him. He has really impacted into the life of youth. He has, you know, he's building a nation. He's building not just some people, he's building the whole nation. You feed someone, train someone to feed, you know, a particular people, I tell you, you are feeding the whole nation. And so he has done a lot. He has done a lot in the life of youth, in our own lives, and generally in the life of all the trainees that are here. And I believe that this step is not just going to provide food for Lagos State citizens, it's not also going to provide employment alone to Lagos State citizens, but I believe it's reaching out to Nigeria as a whole, and not just to Nigeria, but to the world. So he's an excellent man, he's a superb man. We say thank you to him. He has given us the best of the best.
By tapping into agriculture, this administration has taken a bold step at ensuring a brighter and rewarding future for the people.
agriculture is the greatest employer of labor, and this project is set up to also stem rural urban migration. If we develop the rural area, we'll be able to curtail or reduce the number of our youth coming to the urban cities for white collar jobs. So in our drive to develop urban area at the same time the rural area, agriculture youth empowerment scheme was set up, address youth unemployment, address rural and urban migration problem, and also enhance the food security of Lagos. Lagos State, with our population, we need to be able to desist from the invertebrate habit of depending on imported foodstuff all the time. We should be able to produce what we eat. If we cannot produce, or at least a reasonable percentage, from 25% to 30%, is what is driving this project.
Agric Yes target is to empower its trainees in four core subject areas. These include vegetable farming, poultry, aquaculture, and beekeeping. It also emphasizes the knowledge of agri-business for its participants.
The program has a concept note which was designed and debated at the floor of the Executive Council and approved. So we know from beginning to end what we want to do. And now the issue is that every year down the program, we have specific targets that we have set out for ourselves.
To effectively do justice to these subjects, Agric Yes has a three-phase implementation strategy. The first phase is a 6-month intensive training centered around the core subjects. The second phase is another 6-month internship period. This allows the trainees to be exposed to international best practices and management techniques in modern agriculture in private commercial farms. In the third phase, being the exit stage, successful trainees are permanently settled in farm estates.
For the past 30 years or thereabouts, I don't know of any program in the agricultural sector that have been so conscious of, you know, bridging the gap between the old farmers and the young farmers. Nowadays, most of our youth don't want to take farming as a profession. They would rather want to ride Okada, sell recharge card, do fast business that will bring in money, but cannot sustain family in the long run. As a result, this program has consciously identified the gap and quickly moved in to bridge that gap by producing 1,000 army that will fit in this gap that we are going to experience.
In the Agric Yes curriculum, intensive farming is the watchword in both scientific and practical ways of maximizing production with limited land input. It thus targets radical expansion in production of vegetables, poultry, aquaculture, and beekeeping.
These four put together, every one of us, we have developed the passion. Coming into Agric Yes, we were reorientated about our passion in terms of entrepreneurial skill was being inputted in us, so such that whatever business, whatever venture we desire to uptake in this field of agriculture, we can boldly say that yes, we are going to make it and succeed in it.
It has really changed my orientation that I want to be a farmer. When I came in, I thought it's just going to be a thing that you just have to do and go away. But by the time I came and I started, I think it's a thing that I can live.
By design, Agric Yes is to equip, engage, and empower youths in Lagos State, an intervention project that will give birth to a group of elite farmers who will extend the frontiers of agricultural development in the state.
Certainly, we have kept to that vision, and what is more important is that we want to ensure that entrepreneurship, the spirit of entrepreneurship, is what guides everything that we are doing. And we are not only, you know, impacting knowledge, you know, cutting-edge technologies, we are also training, molding character, letting them be good and responsible citizens, community leaders in future. So the vision is really is what has kept us going, and we are very happy that we are keeping to it.
In addition to the status of Lagos as the nation's economic, commercial and industrial capital, Agric Yes program will no doubt bring a fresh breath of air into the state's economy by setting new standards in modern agricultural production for Nigeria. With the expected empowerment of 1,000 laptop-carrying farmers who will set up their own businesses and employ others, government is equipping a brand of determined and highly ambitious young agro-entrepreneurs that are set to unleash their potentials in agriculture.
The experience is just something that it's going to take me days and months to count down. I just came up with something as I was standing and waiting interview that Lagos State government is like a gun and we present here, we are like the bullets and they've just shot us and the sky is just our limit. We are also laser guided, so we are not going to miss target.
It's just as if I'm being induced again to, you know, get the drive to move this agriculture thing in Nigeria forward and most importantly, Lagos State.